How's it going?
All right.
Take a look what you got here.
All right.
Appreciate it.
Jesus.
Cool.
I put some new batteries in it.
Nice. Oh yeah. That's 15?
Yeah.
All right. There you go.
Thank you, sir.
I appreciate it, man.
Yes, sir.
And
I'll let you know if I find anything I wasn't able to really look earlier.
Yeah.
Oh, that you pulled that nut.
I see a lot of them, especially like them and that one. What I had done was when probably about 10 years ago, they wasn't even GameStop, it was Play and Trade.
Yeah.
I went and I had them special order me that game right there.
It's a good game. Capcom made some really good Disney games.
And that's why I had them. I wanted it so bad. I wound up paying like $15 for that. They ordered it offline and had it shipped to the store.
Beetlejuice, that's such a good movie. All right, $20. Where's my wallet?
If you was gonna put a price on that bucket, Mom, what would you put on?
There you go. How's it going?
All right.
Take a look what you got here.
All right.
That's in good condition.
Oh, yeah.
Fantastic. Game manual. All right. Cool. $30?
Yes, sir.
There you are, man.
All right.
I appreciate it.
You good on the other thing?
Yeah, man. I got like two of those at the house, so I'm good on this.
All right.
You got anything else, though, at the house?
No, not right off.
All right. Well, if you come across more stuff, let me know, man.
All right. I will do.
All right. Appreciate it, buddy.
Yes,
complete in box. Pokemon Silver and a fantastic Game Boy DMG. $30. Okay, folks. I just picked up this complete in box Pokemon Silver and original Game Boy DMG for $30. Found it on Facebook, and I went ahead and tested Pokemon Silver, and the battery does not save. So this is going straight on eBay. I don't collect Pokemon, but for $30, I could not pass this up. I can sell this complete with a brand new battery for around $80. And but the first thing we need to do is to get the battery changed in this cartridge. So you've got to remove the screw. You're going to slide down the cartridge like so, and then pop the top. This label is in very good condition too. Look at that label. Not a scratch on it. Awesome. Here is the battery. And we've got to get this changed out. So how I do this is I take a butter knife and I wedge it underneath to give it a little bit of tension. And then I just hit these solder points with my soldering iron and the battery will pop right off. Then we've got a replacement right here. I usually order these in bulk. You can get them by a 10 pack or 12 pack, 15 pack, 20 pack. And they're a lot cheaper if you order them in bulk versus ordering them individually. But this is my last one. So this is going to be put to great use, being able to get this complete in box version sold. So I've got that wedge underneath and now we want to just heat up that solder and it should pop right off like so. And then we're going to do the same for this side and we can just pull it right off like that. Just like that. All right. Now we want to get our replacement and then we just line up positive with positive, negative with negative, reflow the solder and we'll be good to go. I'll pop the cartridge back into the Game Boy and give it about a 2 minute run and then save it and we should be good to go. If I'm not mistaken, yeah, the bottom of this battery is going to be positive. There you go. You can see where it says the positive sign right there. So you just look for the bottom tab here and line it up with the positive side on the board, which will be hard to see, but there's the positive side and then there's the negative side right there. So I'm going to re-solder this battery back on and then we will throw it in the Game Boy and see if it saves. Okay, so there is the new battery soldered back in and we will get it put back into the game cartridge. And then throw it in the Game Boy and get it tested. Alright, let's get it in the Game Boy. Okay, so just now leaving Professor, going outside, and now we're going to try to save this. Alright, now we should be able to turn it off and pick right back up where we left off. It should say continue if the battery is good. If not, it'll just say new game. And it says continue. So it's got a brand new battery in it and it saves. Fantastic. Alright, now we can get this listed on eBay with a brand new battery and show that it saves. The next issue that we need to deal with is going to be this Game Boy. Now he said it was in good working condition. I took his word for it because I've bought items from him before. But upon further inspection, and I probably should have done this when I went to meet up with him, but like I said, I've bought from him before. This Game Boy has issues, and I'm about to show you what those issues are. It's got missing pixels. So if we turn the contrast all the way down, you can see right here is missing pixels and over here. And so we've got to get that fixed. It's an easy fix. We'll just have to take the Game Boy apart. But what you want to do is take your Game Boy apart. You want to remove the screen side so that you can connect it to the board, install batteries, and you want access to the screen. Down here right underneath the screen on this brown ribbon, there's going to be this little black strip right here. You're going to want to remove that, and underneath this is a small adhesive strip that I removed, and it's right here. Not sure if you can see that. And you remove both of them because you want access to this brown ribbon. Now, in order to fix these dead pixels, you're going to turn your screen on, turn the contrast all the way down, and then you're going to want to take your soldering iron with the widest tip that you have. A skinny tip is going to take a little bit longer. And you're just going to run it back and forth over that brown strip there. And this is heat resistant, so it can take a little bit of heat. You just don't want to leave it sitting in one spot. You're going to move your soldering pad over back and forth. So like if I do it right now, you can see how those pixels are coming back. See that? And you just give it time to finish jerking around and moving around. And what I just did is I heated up that solder that's underneath and I reflowed it. And so it's bringing those pixels back. So I'm going to have to do it right there for that, for this centerpiece, and then over here. And then once all the pixels are back and it's all cooled off, we're good to go. Okay, so for the entire time that it took me to take the Game Boy apart, get to the screen, take the rubber off, and get down here to the brown strip here to reflow those lines, it took me about 6 or 7 minutes. But 6 or 7 minutes later, and we've got all the pixels fixed. Let me adjust that contrast there. You can see the bar, no missing lines. We are good to go. You have any more old games?
No.
Like Nintendo, Super Nintendo, N64, GameCube, anything like that? Okay.
I know we used to have a Nintendo, but one of the older ones, but we sold it.
I think me and your dad agreed on $30.
Yeah, sure. You getting?
Yeah, it was everything.
All right.
All right, cool. All righty. Well, there's $30 for your dad.
Thank you.
Appreciate it, man. Thank you. Okay, YouTube. So, very short recap. A lot of what I've picked up, I've already sold. I still have some things to sell, and I have some things going into the collection. So, what I have left for sale is this Pokemon Battle Arena. I picked this up for $1.99 at Goodwill. These sell anywhere between $35 to $40 in this condition, just the Battle Arena. $35 to $40 plus shipping, so it kind of totals out to around $50 to $55. Champions Return to Arms, that is also listed. This is just an extra Tetris that came with the Game Boy lots. Picked up this Xbox One controller in fantastic shape for $4.99 at Goodwill. I plan on trading this in to GameStop. I'm going to try to build up, you know, some major credit over the next year throughout 2020, because PlayStation 5 is coming in, and I don't want to have to pay $500-$600 or whatever it's going to sell for. Picked up God Hand and Biker Mice from Mars along with Luigi's Mansion on the GameCube for $20. I sold Luigi's Mansion for $34.99 plus shipping, made all my money back, a little bit of profit, and I get to keep those two games for free. At the pawn shop, I found Ghost Hunter, which is a game I've been looking for quite a while. I hear a lot of good things about it. So picked up Ghost Hunter, Run Like Hell, Gauntlet Legends, Mario Party Island Tour, and Mortal Kombat 11, all for around $22. And I sold Mortal Kombat, I believe, for $24 or $25 plus shipping, recouping almost every single penny that I spent at the pawn shop that day. So adding in those four games to the collection. And then I picked up a Game Boy lot. If you don't know, I've been trying to acquire as many Game Boys as I can because I've been getting into modding them. Reshell, backlight screen, Bivert chip, which enhances the contrast on the screen. I can do custom buttons. I can do custom LEDs in a clear shell so that the whole thing lights up. Different color LEDs on the battery light. Just the whole works, and I've been having a lot of fun doing it. So if you have not seen my Game Boy modding videos, I have about three or four of them up on the channel. I know a lot of my viewers tend to gravitate more towards the game hunting aspect of the channel, but if modding is something you enjoy and you know, a topic that you like watching on YouTube, well then by all means go and check out those videos. And if you have any desire to purchase a modded Game Boy, let me know. I can customize it to almost any color shell you want, any color buttons you want, and just message me on Instagram. You can find my Instagram link in the pinned comment to this video, so just get in touch with me. But I picked up this Game Boy lot for $30, and I have already completely refurbished this Game Boy. It's got a brand new screen on it. It still has the protective film on it, so it doesn't look perfect, but once you peel that protective film off, it is perfect. This brand new screen, and cleaned the shell from the inside out. The boards have been cleaned. The buttons, everything about this Game Boy is in pristine condition. Got that listed, and a refurbished Game Boy should make enough money. Well, it will make enough money for me to be able to have this Game Boy for free, and these five games for free, which are Tom and Jerry Frantic Antics, Ninja Turtles Fall of the Foot Clan, Amazing Spider-Man 2, one I've never seen before, Tasmania Story. This might not be that uncommon of a game loose, but it definitely is complete. This game right here, complete, is going for $100 plus. So the box and manual must be pretty difficult to find. And then Battletoads. I didn't have any of those games, so all five of those are going into the collection. And that came with a Handy Boy and a Game Boy rechargeable battery. But there you have it, folks. That is all I have picked up recently. Hope you've enjoyed the content. If you have, go ahead and hit that like button. Be sure to subscribe, and when you do, hit the bell icon so you receive all notifications every time I upload new content. Hope you have had a fantastic week. I know I have. I'm Tatted Collector, and have a good one.